Here is my exercise file, Basic Queries. In this tutorial, I want to talk about creating a calculation in queries. A calculation in general in Access is called an expression. So how do I create a calculated field that doesn't exist in the source tables? Let's have a look at one of the tables, Table Order Item. And in this table, I have multiple fields. Among the fields, I have a quantity and I have a price. But I don't have a line total. I wish I could create a field that multiplies the 100 by 3, the 400 by 175, but in Access, we do not multiply numbers like what we do in Excel. In Access, we multiply a field by another field. When you use a field in a calculation, you do not use the caption of the field, which is the user-friendly version. You use the developer name of the field that we see in Design View. Any field name must be included in square brackets. So what I'm going to do is to create a query, and in this query, I'll be creating a new field and I'll be calling it total. And in this total field, I'll be creating a calculation that multiplies the quantity field by the price paid. And because this field doesn't exist in the source table, we'll have also to take care of formatting. Let's close this table and create this calculated field in a query. I close the table, and to create the query, I go to the Create tab. On the Create tab, I click on Query Design. Which table do you want to use? I want to use Table Order Item, so I double-click on this table. And then I close the Show Table dialog box. Here are the different fields I have in Table Order Item. And let's say I want this field, the LNG Item Order ID. And let's say I want the field, Quantity field. And I have the unit price, CUR item price, that kind of unit price. Before I start creating my calculated field in a new column, I want to look at this query. So I run the query. And when I run the query, these are the fields that will be returned. Order ID, quantity, and price. And I'll be creating the calculated field. I switch back to Design View. And in Design View, I put my blinking cursor in this cell. I could type directly in this cell, by the way, no problem at all. But the issue is, I want to make it easier for you to follow up. So I'm going to right-click, and from the right-click menu, I'll select Zoom. What does the Zoom window do? Well, the Zoom window is just a bigger window of the same cell, as if you are looking at the same cell, but in a bigger size. So what I'm doing here is exactly the same as if I was typing it in the same cell. First of all, I have to provide the new field name. And let's say I want to call it total. For Access to understand that this is a name, it should be followed by a colon. So I type a colon. And then I start creating my calculation. My calculation consists of multiplying the quantity by the price. So because I'll be referring to fields, I have to type each field name in square brackets. So I type an opening left square bracket, and then I'll be typing the field name, SNG item quantity. And I close the square bracket. I want to multiply it by the unit price, so I type a multiplication symbol, and then for the price, I'm going to open a square bracket one more time, and the name of the field, the developer name of the field is CUR item price. And I close the square bracket. This is how simple it is creating a calculated field. What you have to know is that you have to use the developer name of the field, and you have to include the field names in brackets. The name of the new calculated field should be followed by colon so that Access knows that this is a name. When I hit OK, the field is created. Let me test. I click on the red exclamation mark, the run button, and now here is the calculated field, and the name of the field is total. The only problem I have is that because it's a calculated field, it doesn't look as nice as the price paid. The price paid is nicely formatted for a reason. This is a field coming from the source table. In the source table, we specify the data type to be currency. And when we specify the data type as currency, it adds the dollar symbol, it rounds up the number, and it keeps only two decimal places. But the calculated field, because it was created in the query, it doesn't inherit this formatting. But we can take care of formatting in Design View. So I'm going to switch to Design View one more time. Now I am in Design View. And in Design View, To the right side of the ribbon, I have Property Sheet. If you click on Property Sheet, then it will open to the right side a pane called the Property Sheet. In this pane, I see a format option, so if I click in this box for formatting, I can click on the down pointing arrow to the right and select currency, and that will take care of formatting. Should you wish to control the number of decimal places, then you click in the box for decimal places, click on the down pointing arrow and select 2. Now I can close the property sheet. What I did so far is that I formatted the calculated field. If I run the query now, you can see that the total field, which is the new calculated field that I created, is nicely formatted. And this is how we create a calculated field in queries.